Welcome back to the Maritime Safety Talk Channel. Everyone knows that the United States boasts the world's most powerful air force. With over 5,200 aircraft operating from 59 active duty bases nationwide. What's even more remarkable is that many of these planes also support roughly 750 U.S. military bases located across 80 different countries. Have you ever wondered how they keep these planes fueled up and ready to go, even when they're flying halfway around the world? How exactly do they transport all that jet fuel to keep these aircraft in the air? And what kind of logistics and technology are involved in making sure these missions run smoothly? Today, we're diving into those very questions. The U.S. Air Force primarily uses specialized tanker aircraft to transport fuel by air. These tanker planes, such as the KC-135 Stratotanker and the KC-46 Pegasus, are designed to carry large quantities of jet fuel and perform aerial refueling missions. Aerial refueling allows military aircraft to extend their range and remain airborne for longer periods without needing to land. The process involves the tanker aircraft flying alongside a receiving aircraft and transferring fuel mid-flight through a specialized refueling boom or hose and drogue system. In addition to tankers, the Air Force also uses cargo planes like the C-130 Hercules or C-17 Globemaster III to transport fuel in portable fuel tanks or bladders when necessary. This flexibility allows the Air Force to support operations in remote locations or areas without established refueling infrastructure. The concept for the C-17 Globemaster III was conceived in 1980 when the U.S. Air Force requested a large transport aircraft that could perform in-flight refueling and operate on rough, unpaved airfields, especially those located at its most forward bases. McDonnell Douglas surpassed expectations by creating a massive flying marvel capable of landing on nearly 19,000 airfields of various types used by the military worldwide. In December 2010, during a mission over Afghanistan, the C-17 fleet reached a significant milestone by surpassing 3 million flight hours. Over its service, the C-17 had covered a distance roughly equivalent to a billion nautical miles. To put that in perspective, it's like a single C-17 Globemaster III making 2,160 round trips to the moon. An impressive feat that highlights its capability to handle long-haul missions, including the transportation of bulk fuel. Thank you. The C-17 is equipped with an innovative aerial bulk fuel delivery system, featuring three large fuel bladders secured within its spacious cargo hold. This system includes two refueling pumps, two diesel-driven engines, flexible hoses, and delivery nozzles. Each bladder can hold up to 6,000 gallons of fuel per flight. When it's time to offload the fuel at the destination, the process is straightforward. Safety checks are conducted, including temperature and other critical stats. Next, the airmen responsible for the delivery, along with the loadmaster, connect and secure the necessary nozzles. Linking the C-17's fuel bladders to the receiving tanks. The fuel can then be transferred into stationary receptacles, fuel trucks, or even directly into other aircraft on the base, especially useful when ground delivery is impossible. The C-17 can also carry smaller fuel containers in its cargo bay, designed for airdropping in situations where on-ground delivery is challenging. Loading these palletized fuel parcels into the C-17's cargo bay requires careful coordination. Once inside, airmen secure the rolling pallets onto floor rails. Arranging them in a single row and attaching them to the static line before takeoff. When over the drop zone, the rear cargo bay door opens and the entire row is released with the static line automatically deploying the parachutes as the pallets exit the aircraft. These operations typically occur at altitudes between 750 and 1,200 feet. With the C-17 cruising at speeds between 130 and 150 knots. The C-17 is a significant fuel consumer, burning through 21,000 pounds of fuel every flight hour. As one of the largest aircraft in the U.S. Air Force fleet, it ranks among the top fuel users. Despite this, the C-17 has the crucial advantage of air refueling, allowing it to extend its mobility missions beyond 2,400 nautical miles. The first successful aerial refueling took place at Rockwell Field in San Diego on June 27, 1923. When one DH-4B aircraft used a hose to transfer gasoline to another DH-4B. This groundbreaking achievement quickly became a pivotal development in aviation history and was rapidly adopted by the industry, including the aerospace sector. Fast forward to 1991, and NASA was testing air-to-air refueling with its SR-71 Blackbird, receiving fuel from a U.S. Air Force tanker.
Lift away from the airplane without getting Fitz's tail. And of course, both.
By this time, the U.S. Air Force had become a leader in aerial refueling, operating massive flying fuel stations like the KC-135 Stratotanker. Between 1956 and 1965, an impressive 732 KC-135 Stratotankers were built and delivered to the Air Force. With nearly 400 still in active service today, this 100,000-pound aircraft boasts a range of over 300 nautical miles, while carrying 200,000 pounds of JP-4 jet fuel for mid-air refueling. With its powerful refueling boom, the KC-135 can dispense more fuel in just 8 minutes than a gas station pump does in 24 hours. The three-man crew, pilot, co-pilot, and boom operator, carefully manages the entire refueling process from start to finish. Aerial refueling, though based on century-old principles, has evolved into two primary methods, probe and drogue and boom refueling. In the probe and drogue method, the tanker releases a flexible hose or drogue, which the receiving aircraft connects to before refueling begins. This method was successfully tested with an unmanned aerial vehicle in 2015. The older boom method, requiring constant supervision from a boom operator, delivers fuel faster, but is more complex and can only refuel one aircraft at a time. The U.S. Department of Defense consumes about 12 million gallons of fuel daily, with the Air Force spending $9 billion annually on fuel. Maintaining fuel quality is critical, requiring advanced laboratories and specialists to ensure fuel is free from contaminants. Proper fuel storage and distribution methods developed by the Air Force are vital for global operations. Thanks for watching. If you found this information interesting, be sure to subscribe to Maritime Safety Talk channel so you never miss out on our latest content. Stay safe and stay tuned for more insights into the world of aviation and maritime safety. See you next time.